ओम अज्ञान, ओम अज्ञान तिमिरन्ध्रस्य ज्ञानञ्जना शलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। नमः ओम विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण प्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय, गुरुदेव की जय। सो वी कवर्ड एंगर मैनेजमेंट फ्यू डेज बैक, विल कंटिन्यू इन द सेम सीरीज। I will share few. I'm not sure any of devotee who has joined today joined in the last session. I will like and request devotee to make it interactive, please. So okay, so I will just go on brief recap. So we discussed three gates leading to hell, and this is mentioned in Bhagavad Gita also. Any devotee remember that? So there are three things mentioned in Bhagavad Gita also, that if we don't control it will lead us to hell.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, is it lust, anger and greed?
Jai. Yes, Mataji. Thank you. Good.
I think it's 2.63, Prabhuji.
Yes, Mataji. Yeah. Okay. Anger is one step shorter to. If we had one single English letter in anger.
Danger.
So that's just shorter to danger. So it's very close. We should be very, very careful. Can we stop anger?
Yes, I think.
Okay, so we discussed that it's difficult to stop anger, but it's easier to manage anger. So the techniques which we learn, it helps us in managing that anger, because we can't stop it. It's a natural reactions inside. You feel upset and something, but how to manage, how to not get angry, control internally as well as externally, that's the techniques. We also discussed three types of anger from Ramayana. Any devotee remember three types of anger from Ramayana? So one was short-tempered.
Yeah, other was when Lord Rama got angry on the ocean, Indian Ocean.
Yeah. So one was short-tempered, second was controlled anger, and third one was spiritual anger.
Mm-hmm. That is Bharata's anger, I think.
Yeah, so that's example, like short-tempered is
Lakshman.
Controlled anger, as you said, Mataji, is Bharat. And spiritual anger is Hanuman. And of course, all anger from Lord is always spiritual anger.
Mm-hmm.
Anger is younger brother of. We discussed Ramanuja, just to give a hint. similar to Ramanuja, there is it's a Kamanuja, Kam Anuj, yeah. So younger brother of lust. If lust is not controlled, anger is going to follow. So it's just younger brother of lust. You have so many hankering desires and it's not fulfilled. High probability that anger is going to follow that. And so younger brother is going to be there. It's okay to be angry, provided for. Yeah, we discussed that. Yes, sometimes it's okay, but it should be right place, right person, right purpose, right situation, and most importantly, right proportion. Yeah. Then, can anger be used for good purpose?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Any example comes, Mataji, in your mind? And it's normally mentioned that how to control or dovetail our anger, lust, and greed in the right place. And for anger, it's mentioned like if somebody is getting or blaspheming devotees or guru or Srila Prabhupada, then we should definitely show our anger. That's the right purpose. Of course, in a proper way. It's not that we should start hitting somebody, but that time to protect our guru and devotees, then it's okay to be angry. Okay. Now just recap on why do we get angry. We discussed lots of examples, lots of things on why do we get angry. Brief. Unfulfilled, unrealistic expectations. Yeah. Many times we have these expectations which are not really realistic and not getting fulfilled, we start getting angry. Wrong assumptions. We discussed one example on one Prabhuji, Mataji traveling in the plane and Prabhuji is taking care of child, Mataji completely in sound sleep. And then with that, people can feel that, oh, she's not a good mother. Yeah. And Prabhuji is taking like the full care of the child from start to end in that journey and really, really struggling hard to manage that, but is still doing. And thing was that it's the one side of the story. We feel like, oh, Mataji is not really a good mother. But the real true picture was that child was not well from last several weeks and mother was taking full care of that child, could not sleep for many nights. And today they are going to their parents' home. And so husband asked mother to please take rest because husband was not able to support. He was not even in the town. So like when we have lots of time wrong assumptions, we make different side kind of a story and we start feeling a bit bewildered and getting upset and angry. Conditioning, we discussed the way we have been brought up, the way we have seen our life. We feel like other person also should react in the same way. And if we don't see that matching, we again start getting angry. Lack of communication. I'm rushing fast in this because this is just a recap. I don't want to discuss again same points, but a quick recap is helpful. Lack of communication. We discussed one newly married Mataji example, how husband used to say something and she used to feel in a different way. Unhealthy comparison. We discussed that how that kind of situation lead to a very wrong perception. Ego and too much rigidity. So that's also lead to this kind of frustration and anger when person is really, really too rigid and having or carrying very high ego. Yeah. Don't want to see anything I've discussed about one example here. Anybody remembers which example? or somebody who reminds you from Bhagavatam, high ego. So we discussed that example on high ego as well as control freak, yeah, that Hiranyakashipu. Excuse me. So Hiranyakashipu was a control freak. He used to feel that I can, like, I have controlled all the demigods, so I can control every single person. And he could not control even his own 5-year-old son, Prahlad Maharaj. Tendency to enjoy. We all are in this world materially trying to enjoy things. And when things are not getting fulfilled, we feel, oh, I could not get 3 BHK house, I could not get that particular car, or I could not get that particular job, or somebody is doing better than me. And then that tendency lead to depression, frustration, and anger. Example, we discussed if someone insulted, cheated, chastised, or neglected. Yeah. We discussed control freaks, perfectionist. Many people who are looking for perfection in their life, day-to-day operation. And if it's not getting met, they feel like, why it's happening with me? Non-acceptance of situation. Yeah, like whatever your situation, they feel like it should happen as per my way. Yeah, they don't want to see what is the plan from Krishna. They see in a very narrow way. Wrong belief and wrong definition of success. Yeah. So we discuss various examples here. We discuss this section also. First 10 techniques on how do we manage anger. Yeah. I'll just have a quick recap. Is that okay with devotee if I have very quick recap like the way I did in past, or should I move?
Yes, Mataji. Yes, Prabhuji. Sorry. You can do the recap.
Thank you, Mataji. So we discussed this cultivate nature of forget and forgive. Yeah. And we discussed that how this really lead to so much challenges in our life. And we discussed one example of boiled potato in Japanese school. They were asked to carry boiled potato in the bag. Yeah. If they have 5 classmates who they don't like, they were asked to carry that boiled potato in that bag, plastic bag, everywhere, wherever they are going, including the restrooms. And after a few days, they were, because it was smelling very heavily, and they were tired carrying these bags everywhere. So, yeah, so we discussed that, like, how difficult and challenging it is to just carry this for 5 days. And many times we are upset with few individuals in our family, in our friends, in our circle, and so much baggage, yeah, so much burden to our health. Yeah. So we discussed that we should not carry this weight and grudging attitude in our mind, which we are maybe sometimes carrying for years. Yeah, it's not really healthy. So we should develop the nature of forgiveness. Yeah. And we also discussed that because if somebody is getting married, yeah, then normally in the Vaishnav culture, it's mentioned that you accept that family also. So if you are boy, then you accept girl's family as your own family and try to compromise, manage, try to keep them also happy, yeah, as part of your own family. Similarly, so if they are making some mistakes or getting upset, you just try to forgive them and move on. Similarly, we are living in this world and we are trying, our ultimate goal is to keep Krishna happy. Yeah. And everybody is part of Krishna family. So if we need to keep Krishna happy, we need to keep everybody else also happy. Difficult task, but something to have a good meditation, that it's important to develop this nature of forgetfulness and forgiveness. Change the direction of arrow. Anybody remembers what does this mean? So normally when we see something going, or like somebody making us upset, what happens? First, our first reaction happens, this person is wrong. Yeah. And we discuss that we feel that we are innocent, completely innocent. But if we change the direction of arrow and start introspecting that something is going wrong here, person is getting upset with me, and or I am getting upset with him, probably it's not just his fault or her fault. Something lies with me also. And then start looking in that dimension. And then our intensity of anger gets reduced. Yeah. So it's just a question of managing the and understanding the difference in expectations versus the actual reality. Yeah. Then right association. Yeah. So we discussed we need to associate with whom, who brings. Who brings best out of us? Yeah. Don't get associated with those who brings worst out of us, because everybody is having both sides of the story. We are having good qualities, we are having bad. Yeah. And if somebody, if we are associating with bad people, if let's say we associate with people who are always blaspheming others, having very negative attitude, negative mindset, we also will carry the same mindset after a few weeks, a few months. Yeah. So right association is important. And we discussed the example of Dhruva Maharaj, where mother Suruchi brought worst out of him, all the bad anger and everything, hatred and everything. And her mother Sunuti, she brought best out of him and made him a devotee. Yeah, that's the quality of right association, that they, even if we are going on the wrong path, somehow they will bring us back to the right path. And will try to give us Krishna Bhakti, Krishna association. Reading scriptures. And we discussed like what happens when we read scriptures. Anybody remembers what happens when we read a scripture? What changes?
Our thinking changes, Prabhuji.
Yes, thank you, Mataji. Yeah, our thinking changes. Sorry, Mataji, I missed.
So, Prabhuji, we are able to cleanse ourselves when we read scriptures. It helps us in cleansing ourselves.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it cleans, it helps our thought process, it changes our awareness, our perception. Rather than being narrow-minded, we become broad-minded. We have read so many good pastimes from Vaishnava Acharya, from Krishna's pastimes and all. Yeah, so. We discussed this example also. If we are seeing any building from the ground floor, from the road, we see some building is looking high, some building is looking different colors, this and that. But when we see the same building from the very high altitude of plane, we don't see any difference. Yeah, we just see a ground with lots of buildings. Yeah, so same thing when we develop that Krishna consciousness and reading this scriptures change our consciousness and purify and cleanse us, change our perception towards every situation. Yeah. So higher we go in Krishna consciousness, we discussed, we don't see the difference in individuals. Yeah. And also we discussed lighter we are. Anybody remember? Lighter we are, higher we are. Yeah. So if you are not carrying any baggage of all these grudges, all this hatred, all this anger towards everyone, we will be feeling very light in our heart. And we are lighter, we'll go higher. Higher in terms of higher in our consciousness. Yeah. So both way, it really helps scriptures reading. And you might have seen like when you are really, really angry, either you chant loudly, or you read, just open any, either Bhagavatam or any scripture, read few verses, you will feel very different. Your anger immediately subsides down. Yeah. Even it's a short term, like of course it's a long term. I'm talking when I say read scriptures, but short terms also it brings that impact. Okay. We also discussed on elevate to goodness. So ABC, chanting, association, book reading, chanting, yeah, sattvic diet, following four regulative principle. Pause for some time and divert your mind. Yeah. So when we are really, really upset, we are really, really like feeling like I should burst, I can't control, try to divert your mind. Change your focus. Yeah. Otherwise, that moment of storm will be very, very dangerous. We will remember that speech or that particular discussion or whatever argument we carry with that individual forever in our life. Yeah. So we should try to control our anger. And in moment of calm, we should try to do introspection. And of course, like if you see, like after a few hours, your intensity of anger will go down. Your thought process will change. Maybe after a few days, you will feel like, why I should get angry? I should not even get upset with that. It's like different situation now. I should move on. Yeah. So that's a kind of good technique, that at that moment, please pause and divert your mind. Chant something, read something, or do whatever way you can divert your mind. Somebody told me interestingly that when I get very upset, I start walking reverse way. It's a practical thing somebody told me, and it works for me. I said, okay, fine, whatever works for you, it's okay. Point is that divert your attention from that anger, angry situation. Avoid triggers and negative spirals. Yeah, we discussed this also. So these all we discuss in this page, that if somebody is creating or bringing negativity with us, try to avoid that particular situation or that individuals. Yeah. Of course, you cannot avoid your own family members, your office, your job, your children, your devotee association. You can't say like, okay, in this temple, I will change this is my president, I will change this devotee, I will change my family. So there is a different technique. We will discuss that in the next just few minutes. But wherever you can avoid, try to avoid those triggers which brings which makes bad to worse. Yeah. Write it down. And we discussed this example. Mataji, Prabhuji, husband, wife, they used to get too much in fighting mode. And his guru mentioned that you should not speak any single word. Whatever you have to express, just put it on the paper. After a few days, they felt, why I should, like, I'm not getting fun out of my anger. So automatically anger got reduced. Yeah. So that's also a good technique, writing it down. And believe me, this is a very good technique. Your intensity of anger will go down very fast. So this is something new we are going to discuss today. Gigo principle, garbage in, garbage out. Yeah. So what's happening nowadays? You see all the children's. In previous world also, people used to see or watch cartoons, but the kind of cartoons people or video games people are, children are having, it's very, very toxic in my view. It's full of violence, full of hatred. They're killing, there is bloodshed, and they're feeling happy. Yes, I killed so many characters. Yeah. So that's the way they are developing their character and their attitude, which is really, really wrong. And many adults also, like they are watching different kind of things on the TV and movies and everything. And even watching news, yeah, that brings really, and many times people start watching news as a first thing in the day and maybe the last thing in the day, which is the worst. Yeah. So that kind of mindset, even they start getting so upset. Why this person, like why this news, why this person is doing like this? Why this political party is doing like this? Unnecessarily anger. Yeah. So it's all garbage in and same garbage out. That's why we try to develop this principle of sattvic diet, sattvic things. And whatever we eat, it's like a machine. Our body is a machine. So if we feed all good things inside, outcome will be good. If we feed all bad things, outcome will be bad. So that's one important thing. Benefit of doubt. We should try to give this space to others, that let's say someone is running late. Yeah. What happens? He immediately starts yelling on that person or really feeling upset. Why you are like late and all. Yeah. We don't allow that person may have some challenge. Maybe certain issue in terms of either maybe traffic issue or health issue or some family issue or whatever. Yeah. But we don't realize, we just see that person should behave as per my way. Yeah. And then no benefit of doubt. Different frame of mind. That also, like, that happens many times, that when we are, even people who are coming to temple, yeah, let's say if morning time people are, they are so used to of greeting others, and one day if some one devotee or two devotee have not greeted them, they feel, why this person is not talking to me today? Yeah, complete different frame of mind. Even on WhatsApp, you send message, and people get upset on that. Like, I can see blue ticks. A person has read my message but not responding. Few hours gone, few days gone, I have sent reminder still. Unnecessary anger. Yeah, maybe person is having a very different frame of mind. Yeah, and that reminds also people who are like, somebody gave this example that he was in one shop. Yeah, and one person, he just realized that one person, a teenager kind of a boy, he's reacting like this, like moving his hand and like something he's going to throw on this Mataji. And she was so angry, why he's going to hit, like, I have not done, even I don't know. But then later she realized that he's having a headphone in her ear, in his ear, and he just listening to cricket commentary, cricket or some commentary, and he just throwing, like, because he got so absorbed in that, he's also trying to imitate the same thing, yeah, mimic the same kind of postures, the way he was hearing. And this Mataji was unnecessarily, he was not at all like thinking what other people are, how people are perceiving that reaction, but she was having so much anger. Yeah, and so that's what happens in our life. Yeah? People are having different frame of mind. Sometimes even they say something bad to us, but that's not that telling from their heart. Yeah, this is like, because of the certain situations, they were so upset in the whole day, and so somehow they just we ask something and they said in a very wrong tone or some way, and we feel like, how come that person is talking to me in this mind, yeah, in that tone. So having that patience, having that tolerance is important. Understanding that person can be in a different frame of mind. Don't give too much value of this material world, yeah, because whatever we will do, whatever best we will do, somebody will find some fault in us. Yeah, can't keep every single person happy in this world. As far as we are doing which is good in our consciousness, we know we are not doing anything wrong, and it's like no wrong intention, then it's all fine. Yeah, that reminds one good story. I'm sure most of you might have heard that, father and son carrying, when they bought a donkey from a market. Yeah. So they bought this donkey, and they were walking along with this donkey, and people started saying that how foolish these people are. They have bought donkey, but they are still not using. So son thought, like, okay, fine, let my father to sit on donkey. So he asked his father to sit on donkey, and he was walking. Then people started saying, oh, how cruel this father is. He's like feeling so proud that he's so big and his son is just walking on the road, no humanity. Then they swapped their position. Now again, same situation. People are saying, oh, how bad this son he's just on the donkey and father is just walking. Yeah. Then they both sat on the donkey. Then they started saying again, oh, how cruel they are. Yeah, they both are sitting, poor donkey. Yeah, they can't say anything. He can't resist. And they both are sitting just like on this poor donkey. So in every situation, whatever they are, whether sitting, not sitting, single, double, whatever, both way, people are just criticizing. That's the way this material world works. Yeah, whatever good we are doing, sometimes people criticize and we start getting agitated. Remove false ego. And this is something where people, like, even knowing all this, still they carry false ego that I am this, I am that, I am at least having this position, I am a senior devotee, I am this particular person in my office, people should behave like this. Yeah. And many times people know our weak points, and they will say, like, and they'll say, see, I am carrying the remote of this person. I can switch on this person's anger in next few minutes. Yeah. And they will say something and we start getting angry. So please don't pass your remote control to others. Yeah. Try to control your false ego. Very important. Yeah. Count your blessings. People normally are very angry because they don't feel grateful. Yeah, they are feeling this has gone wrong, this has gone negative, this is not happening with me, I'm just doing, and they, whatever happens, they start yelling on others, they start behaving in a very negative attitude. But to counter that anger or counter that depression, best is to count on your blessings. Yeah, thinking that Krishna has given so much to me, and building that nature of gratitude. Yeah, attitude of gratitude. That really helps many times, because what happens now, let's say if you start developing this nature that every day I need to appreciate at least two or three people. Yeah. Whatever, whether in my family, whether in my work, what will happen after a few weeks, a few months, you will build this nature and habit of appreciating others. You will not try to blaspheme anybody. You will not try to criticize anybody. You will not try to criticize even your own situation. You will say, okay, fine. Yeah. Because now you have got this habit inside you where you have to appreciate others. Yeah. And that's a very good habit. Even there is not many good quality in others, whatever good quality they carry, try to appreciate those, because that will help. It's not like in terms of just to get that appreciation in return. Point here is that developing this attitude of gratitude. Yeah, so we don't get too agitated in the negative situations. Give up unhealthy comparison. Yeah. So anybody like have this kind of any example in this unhealthy comparison, what happens, and then why we start getting upset and angry? Okay, in our like family life also this happens. Many times we feel that like why should we doing like this because other wives are doing like this, or same happens other way. Mataji feels Prabhuji should do this way because every other I can see he is doing so much, he is supporting this much and all. But everybody has got different quality. Yeah, somebody can do something, somebody can do, like if we ask birds to swim, cannot. Yeah, because bird has quality to fly. Similarly, everybody is having unique soul. They are having different quality, different way to react every situation. We should try to avoid this unhealthy comparison, because when we avoid this, many times this angry situations can be avoided. Yeah, we discussed also like Prabhuji, they are normally very goal oriented, while Mataji are process oriented. Yeah, they will like try to explain everything that what happened in the whole journey. This is the way that happened. They met. She met with somebody. She conveyed this way, and then or like if she's going to buy something, then she bargained with shopkeepers and tried to get so much discount and all. Most of the time Prabhuji, they are not very much interested in all that process. Yeah, they want, that's a male psychology, that they want goal kind of things, what exactly happened finally. Yeah, whether you bought or not bought, whether you got this or did not get. Okay, whether this was a success or failure. So they just want to see the result rather than going through the whole process. Yeah. So we need to understand individual's nature. We should try to understand each other's own property. And based on that, we should try to avoid this unhealthy comparison in our family, in our office, and other places. Even people do this, they get so upset that if they are manager, somebody in their team is working so nicely and somebody is reacting in a different way. And they just like can't tolerate that. Learn to accept failure. Yeah, important, because this normally happens with our children. Yeah, we don't teach them how to face the failure, how to learn. Yeah, And what happens when any situation comes where they are struggling, they feel very, very confused. And many times in India, as well as outside also, you might have seen children normally carrying that much of pressure that they need to get this much of grade in their exams, and that particular grade is not there, then they feel very, very depressed. Yeah. Few, in fact, go to the verge of suicide, which is so worse situation, because they cannot face, like parents have not given the right value or right teaching, and children also have not learned properly. And when children are not getting that right grade, parents are getting that much upset. Everybody is like in that situation. We have not thought about the contingency, and just like when that situation is not happening, we are really, really reacting in a very bad way. Yeah. And trying to get sometimes success with hooks and crooks and all kind of material ways, which is really not good. Yeah. So very important that we learn to accept failure, and also teach everybody and take failure in a positive way, do the introspection and see how we cannot repeat that in future. Keep space for other people's mistake. Yeah. When we are learning driving, first thing instructor tell us that keep space between the car, especially in India when you are driving. Sometimes you are just driving perfectly fine. Somebody can brake immediately without giving any sign. They can take right turn, they can take left turn. So in that situation, only possibility is that you keep a space between the two cars. Yeah. Same thing applies for our situation. When somebody is getting upset or angry, you need to have some space. Yeah. We need to think through some different way, like how this person, like if somebody is, let's say if you're inviting somebody, maybe you want them at 6 o'clock, you tell them that please come, tell the timing at 5:30. So you are giving that 30 minute slot, or maybe something is dependent, like they are coming and third person has to do something. So you tell that third person also, there might be some delay or some contingency, how we can manage. So it's managing and planning properly rather than getting upset and landing into a very angry mode. Yeah. So keeping that space in every situation with others, with people, for people mistake, it's really, really good sign. Yeah. And Guru Maharaj always said that this was one of the Vaishnava principle, organization and planning. Yeah. Don't expect perfection. Yeah. So people who are perfectionist, what they see, if that perfection is not happening, anyway, they are going to be angry mode, yeah, or depression. So please try to avoid that perfection kind of situation. Like if somebody is not responding in a way where you want to see them, always be ready with kind of contingency plan. Give up enjoyer propensity, yeah, and learn austerity. Because in material world, we are just trying to enjoy. Yeah, we discussed this as one of the cause also. We are trying to have fun in this material life, but this material life is not going to give us fun because we are in the dukhalaya, in the place of misery. Yeah. So if we don't get that fun, don't get that enjoyment, we get too much upset. Yeah. Angry mood develops, and like we get so much frustrated that why this is happening. Yeah. So try to avoid this enjoyer propensity. We need to focus as per Bhagavad Gita and learn the austerity. Yeah. Austerity of mind. If you remember in chapter, if I'm not wrong, chapter 17, yeah. Austerity of mind, austerity of body, and austerity of speech. Yeah. So if we focus on these austerity and avoid this enjoyer propensity, then we will be very happy, because we discussed that only one person can be enjoyer. And who is that person? As Krishna has mentioned in 529, Bhoktaram yagya tapsam sarvloke maheshwaram. That means Krishna is the only ultimate enjoyer. If we try to take Krishna position, ultimately we are not going to be happy. Yeah. So developing this nature. No anger zone in your home. Sometimes it's good. Like I have seen people even here as well as in India. People try to have few zones in their house where you cannot be angry. This is a temple room. There is no way you can be angry. This is my kitchen. Kitchen, there is no way you can be angry. So that way, like they develop that kind of zone, and that helps at least to avoid some anger in those places. And one Mataji mentioned that she controlled her children. Whenever children are upset, she will say, oh, this particular place is not at all. This particular time is not right for being angry. So she's trying to avoid anger in every situation, in every place. Yeah. So try to have that no anger zone in your home. Deal in same currency or page. Yeah. Many times we have wrong assumptions. Yeah. We feel that people, because these are not validated assumptions, and we get so upset with them. Even simple example, like if you are scheduling a class, yeah. A few weeks back that happened with one devotee who scheduled one class. It was for international, it was a kirtan. He scheduled that kirtan and he sent that timing for international devotee. And that devotee could not join. And because it was back-to-back kirtans and all kirtaniers lined up, and he sent so many reminders and everything, and he was so upset, why this person is not joining? Only challenge was, he did not mention the timing in the local way. Yeah, he mentioned timing in his own way, and that person is thinking time in that own local. So just like we need to have the same currency, same page, let's try to be on the same page, same currency, yeah, in the same atmosphere, same environment, same situation. Try to see in that way, our anger might be reduced when we see in that way. Dovetail our anger to doing positive. Yeah. So it's important, like we discussed, like many other techniques, that when we are angry, how to dovetail that anger to positive side, or trying to have any pause. And as we discussed earlier, that if we are really, really angry, we should try to dovetail that anger to someone who is getting offensive to our guru or offensive to our devotee. Yeah, that's the better way to dovetail our anger in the right mode or right mood. Like the way developing, we discussed like three things which are leading to hell. Yeah, so lust, anger, greed. So anger we can dovetail in Krishna, protecting our devotee. Lust we can dovetail. Lust means like hankering to do more and more, or desiring to do get more and more in terms of Krishna service. And then greed, which is very, very bad. So that greed we can dovetail in serving Krishna devotees or guru and others. Yeah. So that way we can dovetail our anger. Sorry, something wrong. Tolerate and take it as my karma. Yeah, I think this is important, because many times we see that in India in the old time, if you remember, postman used to carry telegram. Telegram is some emergency message. Yeah, right now there is not such kind of things. Everything is over phone or over the message. But they used to carry important news, like somebody, because there was no phone at that time. So if they are carrying any good news, you don't hug them. If they are carrying that somebody died, you don't beat them. Yeah. Similarly, in our situation, we need to understand, whoever is getting upset with us, it's just our karma. Maybe sometimes we were very angry with individuals, and now this karma is coming back. Yeah. And if we start behaving and thinking in that way and tolerating in that way, our consciousness will change. And I remember Jiva Goswami very nicely mentioned this particular line, that all these good people, Yeah. So his point was that all people in this world are good people, first of all. And his point was that all these good people are in this world are forced to behave badly with me. Why? Just because of my karma. So such nice way to handle that situation, that people are so nice, it's just my karma, because of that they are behaving badly. Yeah. And that's the way many Maharaj, you might have heard, to treat this anger. And also many times people say, if somebody is getting upset and if I don't show my frustration and anger, they may take this as my weakness. Yeah. But honestly, if in your office also you can see, if you like are working as a boss or manager, and in your team somebody, if you are trying to manage coolly, they will be more closer to you rather than you try to have that distance and always upset and all that kind of angry mood just to keep that distance or gap. Yeah, that does not develop in terms of proper relationship. Yeah, so when we start thinking that, okay, like everything is my karma, just like let's tolerate it. And when if I can't tolerate, and the saying goes, no, that if I can't cure, then just endure. Yeah. So try to endure, try to tolerate. It's very important. We can be assertive, toleration is very, very important, because it's chapter 2, yeah, Bhagavad Gita, that matra sprashestu kanteya, yeah. So that's there also Krishna is saying that we should develop this nature of tolerating, whether it's a good or bad, because if somebody is getting upset, I'm sure at some point of time he'll be okay also. Yeah, but if we react badly, then that situation can go from bad to worse. Yeah. In fact, like Narad Muni mentioned in his pastime, then when he told a snake not to bite but to hiss. Yeah. So if situation we have to react, just respond in an assertive way rather than aggressive way. And the last point which is mentioned here is pray to Lord. If nothing is working, whatever techniques you have applied, nothing comes to your defense, then only shelter is Krishna. Everything is being controlled. Every situation is being controlled by him. Every individual is being controlled. Every soul, because he's sitting as a super soul in everyone. Yeah. So he knows what is good for us. We should try to have that faith, try to have that full, strong, unflinching faith, that faith on Krishna, that whatever he is going to do, even people are getting upset, people are angry, people are blaspheming me, people are chastising, in spite of I am doing all good and I am not doing anything bad, why people are like treating me in a bad way, why every situation I am being seen as like I'm doing wrong thing. Krishna is knowing everything. He is having a bigger plan for you. Praying to Krishna, he can, by his mercy, every situation we can change, every obstacle we can cross. Yeah. He like mentioned very clearly in 9.22, if I'm not wrong, where he's saying that whatever we lack, he provides. Yeah. So it's very important that we have full faith on Krishna. And of course, we cannot be perfect in one day. But at least by going through these techniques, we will have right consciousness. Yeah. And it's like question of when these kind of situation happens, either you can be thoughtless or you can be thoughtful. Yeah. And thoughtful way of handling any situation will help you in better way of managing anger. So, and ultimately, like, why to worry or why to get upset when there is Lord? Hari, yeah. So we should just have faith and surrender to Krishna. And of course, like all these techniques, which are some material level, some spiritual level, helps us in controlling this anger. Yeah. So I will request devotee to share, like last time, any questions or any relations or any their comment, any examples which they have gone through, anything which you think out of this technique, which one you feel like might be helpful for you, please try to open, unmute yourself or type in chat window.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. All glories to Guru Maharaj. Thank you very much for this lovely session. Prabhuji, like you mentioned, one of the tips that I'm using is that I kind of make a promise to myself that I'm not going to get angry. And every time there is a sensation of getting anger, that promise just comes up. So it's a almost a reminder to the self that that's what a promise I've made to myself. So that really helps me. I just thought I'll share with you.
Oh, that's really good, Prabhu. That kind of concept and thought process that is like whatever happens, I'm just going to tolerate it. I'm going to make sure that I don't react. Maybe I can respond, but I don't react. That's why Guru Maharaj gave you name also, Dhir Prashanta. So,
Hari Bol, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you.
Thank you, Hari Bol, Prabhuji. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Can you hear my voice?
Yes, Mataji can hear.
Yes, okay. Dandavat Pranam, first of all. I would just like to share that in kids, when they are at the younger age, sometimes it happens, we have the... In many families, they have the habit of labeling people for their anger. Like we many times when kids are influenced by the surrounding people, they have the tendency of getting angry. So, we take it granted that he or she is getting very angry. And we keep telling them that, you have an angry nature. You are short-tempered. So we keep labeling them again and again. And we remind them that, you have a short-tempered nature. So this is something I really have noticed and which should not be done. Rather, we should give them, try to give them solution or a remedy when they face such a situation. And when they successfully do it, if they work out with the thing and, tolerate their anger, at that time, we should, encourage that kid more that, that's a wonderful thing you made out. You tolerated your anger. That's the very good thing you did. You should encourage those points rather than keeping them reminding, you are short-tempered. You are your nature is such. Your nature is such. Because when in the young age they have the imprints or the labels of carrying, you are angry. You are angry. Then they when they go in the long run, it's very difficult to get out of their nature. So this is one thing I have noticed. So that's what I would like to share.
Thank you, Mataji. I agree. And sometimes people go to the other tangent. Like if someone is angry, we discuss that. What if they try to develop more fire out of that? If somebody is getting upset, and many times you might have seen people are getting upset and they are having some physical way to react and respond. Sometimes they stammer and all. And people try to imitate them. Try to ignite more fire in that, like mirror their style. But we should try to avoid really in that situation, not to mirror that style, listen him coolly and at the right point, as you said, try to tell them that maybe they are doing something wrong here, or like they should not go this way. This is a better way to manage this kind of situation in a positive way. Even like Krishna also in the Bhagavad Gita first chapter did not say anything to Arjun. He just tolerated. He just listened carefully. All the things. When Arjun brought everything out and he was completely bewildered, then only Krishna started speaking. But even Lord himself gave that opportunity. So yes, we at material level should definitely try to give that opportunity to others, not to increase their anger by a situation, but try to help them by coming, getting them out of that situation, not only in that time, but maybe for future. So thank you, Namrata Mataji. I think very good point.
Yeah, thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Any other devotee has got any, or any other techniques which you think we have missed, or like it might be good to really understand? Okay. So looks like no further question, Lavanya Mataji.
Yes, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Yeah, thank you so much for the session, Prabhuji. And I like these points, like where mom is using this no anger zone and no anger time. That is a good thing. I think I will implement that from now on. And yes, we have to be careful, like as Namrata Mataji says, that labeling is a bad thing. Yeah, I don't like it. Like we'll just based on their some behavior, we'll just label. Even kids also sometimes we say, oh, they are like this, they are like that. But even if they want to change also, when we say like that, they get angry, like I want to change and why you are labeling me like that. So that's a difficult thing to change, but with conscious behavior, I think we can change that. So that anger may not be triggered at that point. Yeah. Sometimes will be a cause of anger also, right, Prabhuji? So so that is another thing which I thought of asking you, like how to manage that.
Sorry, Mataji, I missed connection issue at my end. I lost like last few.
Yeah, I am telling that sometimes we'll be the cause of that triggers, like anger triggers to someone like who will get angry. But at that time, how should we do? How should we handle the situation?
I think that's what we discussed, Mataji, that like all these techniques, because these all techniques will help us in terms of controlling our anger and keeping us calm in those angry situation, because like either pausing or like writing way or think tolerating that way at that moment, you know, all these kind of techniques helps us controlling our own anger, because if we are not controlling it, will be definitely bursting, we will be bursting it out, yeah, at some point of time, whether internal anger or external. You might have seen, like we discussed this last time, that people many times don't show their anger, yeah, but they just try to keep that within, yeah.
Yeah.
That time, simple example, you ask them, probably like ask them for or invite them for something, yeah, like they will have very deep breathe and they will not try to say anything. They will try to, okay, just like from the reactions, from the bodily postures. So people react in a different way, and even explosive or implosive, but whatever way, at least for us as a devotee, when we are trying to move to this Krishna consciousness path, we should try to develop these all qualities, at least these continuous reminders of all these qualities and all these things again and again helps us in building the right consciousness and controlling bad qualities within us, anger, lust, greed, all this really. So, but important is that not to respond, not to react immediately, seriously. That's the most critical thing, that at least like one thing we need to try developing after this, that even something worst comes, not to immediately react in a very bad way. Yeah. I hope that answered.
Yes, Prabhuji. Yeah. Thank you. Shri Devi Mataji.
Yeah.
Hare Krishna. Just one point I wanted to add, that by the example of Telegram, what you told. In previously in India, used to have the Telegram services. So you don't get instant messages because of used to have phones, and letters used to reach, you know, after some days. So the message, even if it is a death of somebody or a good news, or it used to reach after some days. So by default, we had the habit of keeping patience and keeping tolerance. But with technology, I think that is reduced. We get instant messages, we get instant reactions. And that can be just one disadvantage of the technology what we are facing. And we might have to be consciously, you know, be aware to keep away from that.
Yeah, technology is not a bad thing, Mataji. It's the way how we utilize that, yeah. So if you utilize that in a right way, then it, of course, it's a very good technique. But more than technology, it's our consciousness, which really helps us in reacting or responding in that situation. So even if Telegram comes, let's say even one day later, then also, even that situation, thing is that we don't, point is that we don't beat that person, yeah, or that postman, because we know he's just a carrier. Same way, if we understand that if somebody is getting upset, it's not that that person is a point of like issue. It's just because he's a carrier, because I was doing something wrong in my past karma or this karma, a past life or this life, and that karma is coming back. So he or she is just a carrier. Yeah. So that really helps, that kind of a thought process, that actually it's just bound to happen because Krishna has devised this way. It's my karma who is coming through this person. So automatically, even you are so upset with that person, that intensity will go down.
Yes, Prabhuji. True. Yes, yes. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Shridevi Mataji, sorry, you raised your hand, but I could not see earlier. Sorry.
Please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada, all glories to Gurudev. Thank you, Prabhu, for really, really emphasizing the importance of controlling anger. I was hearing very carefully to all the things that you mentioned. And one thought just came to me. I just want to share that really speaking, very careful attention to chanting the holy name can greatly help us and will greatly help us to break out of generational patterns of behavior, one of which is anger. You know, I can tell you for a fact that I come from a family where, you know, we wear our anger like a badge of honor, which is very sad, actually. If one wants to be a devotee, one has to overcome these tendencies. So good sadhana will help us to really not be reactive, to stay in the mode of goodness, to give the benefit of doubt, to change our mindset. So many things that you mentioned will come automatically by really paying very careful attention when chanting the holy name. So I wanted to just emphasize that when we make our sadhana strong, many of these tendencies will just fall away and we will be able to overcome. So just wanted to share that. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji. Absolutely right. Because chanting and listening or reading scriptures, these are two things which really, really are the most powerful weapon in handling any situation. Because that will, as you were discussing, that will help in changing our consciousness. All things are going to change maybe at that point of time, our thought process. But these two change our consciousness completely. And we don't see anything in a short term or narrow way. We start looking at everything in a broader terms, that everything is Krishna plan. Everything belongs to Krishna. Everything is part of Krishna family. So why to like react in a wrong way? So yes, absolutely agree, Mataji. Thank you.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So Mataji, there is no question or no comment. If from any devotee, maybe we can close now.
Yes, Prabhuji. Yeah.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Guru Maharaj.
Gurudev ki jai. Anant Koti Vaishnav Brind ki jai.
Jai. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Nice class.
Hare Krishna.
So will you share this PowerPoint thing?
I will share Mataji after today. Yeah.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
I will send it to you, Mataji. You can send it.
Yeah, sure.
And please send to me to Vrindavannath Prabhu. I would appreciate.
Okay, Mataji. I will send to you Lavanya Mataji and Namrata Mataji. So,
Dhanut Pranam, Prabhuji, please accept my humble obeisances. Thank you for the very nice class, very practical class, and the very nice techniques you have shared. Thank you. Can you also share with me, Prabhuji?
Yeah. Sure, Mataji.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.